class, Earth Environmental Science senior thesis seminar is composed of both environmental studies majors as well as earth science majors, and those earth science can be environmental science, geology, and paleobiology. So we have a really broad spectrum of projects all within the seminar. So there are a few different goals, but two of the biggest goals of the seminar are obviously to help guide them through both conducting their research and writing up their project, but also giving them the opportunity to learn about the wide range of research that is done in the earth and environmental sciences. And so this is kind of a good place for them to experience giving and receiving feedback.
It appears that we have three separate instances of convergent evolution occurring.
I'm trying to understand why fishes have evolved elongated noses. Basically, I found that if you look at the pattern of evolution of elongated snouts over several hundred million years, that pattern is actually distinct from what you see when you look only at modern groups. And basically, the big takeaway message from that is when we try to study patterns of evolution in modern groups, we should use the fossil record because there are patterns that occur over broad timescales that we can't observe when we just look at modern animals. So the senior research seminar I really like because it put me into an environment with a bunch of other, you know, people my age who are also really interested in research. Getting criticism is always difficult, particularly when you're really proud of something, but I think it's a good process because if you want to be in science, obviously all of science is built around peer review and criticism. So I think it's a good skill both to learn how to do it and to learn how to take criticism and make something better. So that's, I think that's something I've liked about the class, even though it's been difficult at times. And obviously it takes a lot of work to do it.
So basically, these environmental parameters constrain these Mittelbach reactions that also...
So students give two-minute presentations throughout the year. And then for the final talk, they give a 12-minute presentation. And this is much like a talk that you would give at, say, the American Geophysical Union meeting or the Geological Society of America meeting. And so they give 12-minute scientific presentations, and then four of those students get selected to give encore performances of those. And then every student gives a poster presentation that is attended by graduate students, faculty, undergraduates, and students from other departments. So it's really a culmination of a year's worth of work for all the students.
So I was working on how vegetation recovers after wildfire in Southern California. I got interested in this topic because I used to live in Colorado and experienced wildfires out there. And with the historic, awful fire season that was happening in California the last 2 years, I wanted to see if I could study something relating to that. And my mentor, Dr. Dmochowski, works in remote sensing, which is really good for kind of getting bird's eye view of how things change over time. So I was interested in wildfires. I'm really interested in climate change and landscape change. And so those kind of seemed like a natural fit for the project. So I learned a bunch of coding and a bunch of data analysis processing for this project. And that's been a really cool experience to learn it kind of really fast and on the fly, which has been a lot of fun.